I'm pretty sure this is one that I've never seen before. Using the filter search box to remove items. Yesterday I was up in Daytona Beach doing a seminar, and Melvin from Orlando hit me with this one that I'm pretty sure I've never seen before. All right, so you all know that if we needed to find all of the apples in this column, we could open the search box, come here to search, and search for apple, and then select all search results, and everything is great. But what if you wanted to get rid of a whole bunch of things? Like over here, category. If I wanted to get rid of all the things that started with C, that would be a lot of unchecking. Now check this out, this is Melvin's trick. I'm gonna type in a C, which gets me a long list of C items. I wanna uncheck all of these. So first step is select all search results, choose that, which effectively unchecks all of the C's, and then to apply these negative checked boxes to the current list, say add current selection to filter, click OK, and look at that, all of the C's have disappeared. Wow, that is awesome. When the question came up from someone else in the room, I initially was going to go into the drop-down text filters, does not contain, or over here in column A, you'd have to go to the text filters, begins with, and then change it to does not begin with, which is down here in the list, C, and Melvin's like, oh, no, there's an easier way, all right? And I have to agree, it's definitely an easier way. So let's say we want to get rid of anything that had a B in it, uncheck select all search results, add current selection filter, click OK, and the B's are gone. We'll try the same thing over here with Apple. Uncheck all the apples, add current selection to filter, and the apples have disappeared. All right, here's another one. I changed up some of the data here. I want to get rid of everything that has apple or berry. So open this, search for apple. Use Melvin's trick. Uncheck that, check this, okay. Then open again, search for berry. Uncheck all the berries, add current selection to filter, and it should remove, it does, look at that. I really wanna know, down in the YouTube comments below, did you know this? Did you know this kind of like way to remove items from a filter? I'm almost sure this is new to me. Thanks to Melvin for passing that along, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.